So I know Barack Obama was a customer here for what, 14, 15 years before being elected to the Senate. Did you ever personally get to cut his hair?
No, never. Only one person has cut his, well, two, has cut his hair. And Zarif has been cutting his hair for like the last 13, 14 years.
Is he here today?
No, he's in D.C.
Oh, he got to go to Washington.
Well, he had to cut his hair last night.
So you're minding the store while Zarif goes off to do the presidential haircut.
Well, I'm always minding the store. Keep it under control. But my brother's also, he's the co-owner, so he's him. But yeah.
That's got to be one heck of an endorsement for this establishment, that we cut the president's hair, that our barbers go to Washington to get the job done.
Yes, it's wonderful. It helps out a lot with business.
When did the phone call come? When did he know that he had to go to Washington to do the honors, essentially?
A long time ago, about 15 years ago.
So even in 1994, he had a sneaking suspicion that today would be the day.
I don't know about that. You have to talk to Zarif. I'm just, but it was started from back then, you know, because it wouldn't have been back then leading up to now.
Tell me a bit about what Obama has done for this shop in terms of just the attention, the people coming in. They want to see where the president came from and what his life was like before he entered, you know, national politics.
It's gained up so much attention that we're put on the national tourist attraction, whatever it is. You know, it's a tourist attraction now. So that's the biggest type of endorsement or advertisement we have. We get people from all over the world coming here just to see where the President of the United States gets his haircut. And that helps out a lot. And some of them come in actually with a haircut because of it. So yeah, international recognition.
I've heard that people do come in here requesting the Obama cut.
Yes, a lot.
What is that, just for people who aren't in the know?
A shortcut all around. Nothing really special. It's just a normal cut that all barbers should know. That's it.
And when was the last time he was in here?
3 weeks before the election. He tried to make an appointment to come in after that, and the CIA wouldn't let him.
What is he like as a customer? I mean, have you talked to him? Have you, you know, hung around with him? What's he like in here?
Like, you could walk in here getting your hair cut. He says hi to people that say hi to him, and tap people on the shoulders that he knows from his past. He'll have a conversation about football, baseball, what your kids are doing. He's just a normal guy, an everyday guy.
So when a Barack Obama is talking about the Bears, you're talking about the White Sox. What are his concerns? What does he talk about?
If they're winning or losing, depends, you know. He's just like every, you know, Chicago fan of sports. He talks about the bad things and the good things, you know, things that he would like to see change and things that he would keep, you know. Just a normal Chicago fan.
Could you get a sense of who his favorite players are?
He likes Devin Hester, and Devin Hester likes him, so... I wouldn't say any particular player that I could come off, you know, get off the top of my head. You would have to ask him personally who his favorite player is.
Yeah, good luck.
Yeah. So.
And then for today, I mean, this has got to be kind of surreal. I mean, you've known this day was coming since November and probably before then because he was doing so well in the polls. But this has got to be, I don't know, is it weird, is it incredible that a former customer, a guy used to come in here and talk about the Bears, is in Washington, and within the hour, he's going to be the President of the United States.
Yeah, it is weird. It's kind of surreal-like. It makes you proud. It makes you nervous and proud at the same time. And I wish him well. I hope he does really good.
And this is doing really good for you guys, too.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, by the way, Rick Fox, you were supposed to come in and get your hair cut in the morning. You did. I want you to come back and get your hair cut.
All right. I will. Thanks.
He made history. They ought to put a statue like Abraham Lincoln for him.
Yeah.
Because he made it possible for Barack to be the president. If If it wasn't for George Bush, it would have been the same as it was before. This is the man. They ought to put him in the history books right next to Obama. Take a big picture, because he made it so bad that we had to have a change. I clap. I applaud this man.
We love you.
I would kiss him if I saw him. He would cringe, but I would kiss him. I swear, I would kiss him. Thank you, George. You did it for us.
Upon our democratically elected leader. Those who doubt the supremacy of the ballot over the bullet can never diminish the power engendered by nonviolent struggles for justice and equality, like the one that made this day possible. No triumph tainted by brutality could ever match the sweet victory of this hour and what it means to those who marched and die to make it a reality.
That's right.
Our work is not yet finished, right, but future generations will mark this morning as the turning point for real and necessary change in our nation.
Profound is a sapping of confidence across our land.